Hello, good day to everyone. So welcome to my another lecture. So thank you for watching my previous lectures and giving me a good review on that. So I have got many replies and many questions regarding the last lectures which I have uploaded in the YouTube videos. So I hope you will be enjoying in future as well. So try to subscribe my channel, so I will be updating most of the modules which is related to seismic data processing in future. So today what I'm going to launch another lecture which is actually a very important thing, which normally we are doing seismic data processing in time. So now we will introduce another lecture which is called the FK transform. So with that transform, which is frequency wave number, so we can remove the noise and use the different filter. So before I go into the details, so we have to know what is FK transform. So FK transform is actually a two-dimensional Fourier transforms over time and space, which is one dimension is your time and another is a space, is also called FK or KF transform, in which F is your frequencies and K is your wave number. So the Fourier transform is actually over space. It is the FK domain. There is a two-dimensional amplitude and phase spectrum, but usually only the former is displayed for clarity, with color intensity used to show the amplitude of the data at different frequencies in wave number. So normally when we are looking at our seismic data, I mean once you look the normal seismic data, in y-axis you have the time and x-axis you have the offset. So to make it more clear and more understandable, so you can divide or you can convert your time domain data into frequency domain. So in that you have the frequency and the wave number. So that one V is quite important and is easier to do the noise filtering. So obviously there are some benefit of doing this FK transform. So the first and most benefit of the FK transform, we can have noise, different noises which we can remove, such as we have the ground roll and some seismic interferences which may be radially separated by FK amplitude domains and rather than the time space domain. So obviously why we are using this FK transform, it is more easy and more understandable, and obviously we have more control on the noise and the data set. I will show you in the next slide. Obviously we have some objective to do this FK transform. So the first objective is to attenuate the unwanted energy, which is normally the coherent noise, linear noise, such as ground roll. So I will show you one of the example how we do the processing or removal of the ground roll using the software. So this is not only the lecture, but we are going to have the hands-on. The second is the guided wave and also side scattered wave. So and also we are doing the dipping feature, such as we can look at the time and distance plane. It can be also separated by FK filtering. So such as diffractions, normally you can separate it out using FK filter, and it allows to eliminate certain type of unwanted energy from the seismic data. And it's also can be applied to the set of traces ordered by distance, such as you want to do in short domain, CMP domain or stack data. So this all data set can be used to have the conversion from time domain to frequency domains. So work as a 2D filter and in a multi-channel process. Obviously you can do in 2D filter, either if you have the 3D data, but obviously you will be doing in 2D domain with the multi-channel processes. So let's look at the theory, how we can convert our seismic data from time domain to frequency domain. So on the first is the one-dimensional transform. So in one-dimensional transform, normally we have our time domain, then we have the Fourier transform, which is 1D transform, then we can get the frequency domain. So in 2D, we have time distance, which is normally, which can be applied two way. One is the FK filter, and the second one is a slant stack time, which is also called tau p transformation. But in this lecture, we are only focusing on 2D FK transform. So if we look at the literature, I mean, obviously we can have a look of the seismic data, which is not is shown here. So let's say in the time domain, we can look at our data. This is our, I mean, reflections. This is the hyperbolic move out. Then this is probably the first break. So how does it look like in seismic data? So this is explained. So this one is a first break, normally appears to be here, and the reflection is coming and it's appeared to be this section, and the reflection, which is the strongest point of our interest, which is normally appears at the 0 cycle per second. So if you look at the real seismic data, in real seismic data, obviously we have the reflection, refraction, ground roll, and air waves. And how does it look like in the FK spectrum? So in FK spectrum, obviously in the y-axis we have the frequencies, and on x-axis we have the wave number. So with respect to this, we can easily eliminate, or we can preserve only the reflection, refraction, ground roll, or the air wave. So either you want to preserve or either you want to remove. So both way you can have the easy access to this. I will show you one example of that one as well. So this is a cartoon diagram, so obviously it is also showing. So normally in FK spectrum, you have, this is 0 cycle per second, and this is away from 0, positive and negative. If you have both side hyperbolic move out, I mean, if you have the split spread shooting, then you will have the both side frequency spectrum. So this is a common workflow, how we work for FK filtering. So in that, we can have the common short gather data, either CMP gather or CMP stack data. So then we apply 2D Fourier transform. So then we can get the already 2D Fourier transform data set. So then after that, you have to define a rejected zone, which is for the amplitude spectrum, and leave the phase spectrum alone. Then again, you have to assign 0 rejected zone. In the zone where you have selected, then you have to define as a 0. Then after that, once you already done the, I mean, a rejected zone with the frequencies as a 0, then you can apply inverse Fourier transform, and finally you can get the FK filter data set. So there is one example over here. So this example is actually showing the FK before, with and without FK transform to remove the ground roll. So over here you can see the low frequency and high amplitude ground rolls over here. So this is without FK and with FK, so you can have the better continuity of the reflections after FK. So this is another example from FX deconvolution example. So over here on the left side is before FK decon, and the after on the right side. So there is obviously some practical issues with FK transform. So in FK transform, actually produce the wraparound noises. Sometimes you want to remove the noises, but it can be enhanced more your noises. Sometimes you have the padding with the 0. So if you assign some wrong area with the 0 crossing, 0 frequency, then you have the padding zone. So size of the input gather increased by the factor 4. So that is also one of the effect. I will show you these all the problems and the issues in the practical example. So in summary, I mean, 2D Fourier transform of time distance is normally converted to the 4 frequency wave number, and even with the same frequency content but different apparent velocities are separated in FK domain, even if they cross the time domain. So finally the FK filter must have ramp to avoid edge effects.
So this is some of the key messages which you want to take for this lectures. So now I will move to the software which is we are going to use the Vista software. So over here you can open the project. So these files you can get from me. So we have this project which is from the Vista. So here is a short gather data which is denoted as short 20 over here. So you can view your data set like this. So these are actually your short record. So this is actually, the shooting. You have the on the left side receivers are increasing. So let me take the complete short record which can be shown here. So over here you can see the complete short record. You have the both side receiver. So just zoom it in so we can select this one short record to do the FK filtering example over here. So there are many other things in the software. You can follow the previous video. So if you go to the seismic analysis window over here, so just to avoid to override this data set, so you can select a copy analysis window of this short record. So once you select this copy analysis, then you can click on the plus sign to execute the analysis options. So once you execute, you will have only one short record. So you can check with this, so the cursor left and right, so there is no other short record. So you have this one short record which is 167, and you have the number of channel is 120. So over here is mentioned. So again, you have to go to seismic analysis window over here. So in seismic analysis window, now you can calculate the average data trace just to look at the amplitude spectrum. So amplitude spectrum actually shows you the variation of amplitude with respect to your time. So obviously you can see in all traces, but if you want to have the average, so you can see the amplitude at the shallower part and until 400 millisecond, you have the quite good amplitude, but below you have not preserved a good amplitude. So just to have a look, an idea, so you can, if you want to save it, either you want to discard, you can discard this. So this one is actually your short record, which we are going to have the FK spectrum and FK filtering. So then you have to select FK spectrum design from the seismic analysis toolbar. So over here you can again run or execute this analysis option. So once you run it, obviously it will convert your seismic time domain data into frequency domain. So on the y-axis you have the frequencies and x-axis you have the wave number. So this is your F and your K is shown here. So you can further zoom in the data set which you have here. So once you zoom in, obviously we have not more than 50 hertz data, so this is mostly around 40 hertz data you have in this. So there is many other methods. So you can define the rejected zone, either you want to select the boxes or either you want to have the rectangle, or you just select like this one. So it's depend on your objective, but here our objective is to remove the ground roll. So if you have selected some wrong things, so you can just delete all the selected area. So the best way of choosing the selected zone is the FK polygon rejected zone. So for here we can choose this one. So this is your zero. So as following the lecture notes, so you can see we have to remove all the noise, all the data. So once you have to leave, you just double click on this, then again you can start from here. I'm just trying this one, so you can have multiple way of selecting this data set. Either you think this is a noise or this is your signal, so this is depends on you. I'm just showing you the example how you can remove the ground roll. So once you have selected the rejected zone, so you can calculate the FK filter. So over here it is actually already assigning zero, so the blue color is your zero. You can look at the legend over here, and And obviously this one is your highest amplitude, which is plus one. So after you have calculated the FK filter, then you can just click on the seismic data with applied FK filter. So this is out, then SPL, then finally apply FK to the input data. So over here, I mean, this on the left side is your data traces before FK, which is shown over here. So and this on the right side is after. So over here you can see your ground roll has been removed, which was this one, and you can have the better reflection over here. Obviously we have removed some of the effects from the reflection here, but for that you have to design a proper filter. So this is up to you, how do you design your filter and how you can improve your seismic data, and you can improve signal to noise ratio. So that was about this FK filtering technique. So I hope you have enjoyed my lectures, and just subscribe my channel to have the further seismic data processing as well as related videos. I hope you can join the other lectures as well. And thank you so much, and have a good day. Thank you.